I'm deciding not to wear the hat. It's official.
It's just too rough for me.
What's up, y'all? Welcome back to my channel. So today I have a very interesting video for you guys. I have a story time for y'all. I'm gonna tell you this story of when I almost got caught stealing a betta fish from Walmart at 2 a.m. So, let's get right into it. So, this was about, I don't know, a year and a half ago. This was like my senior year of high school. So, I had a best friend, and for like her privacy sake and all that stuff, I'm going to call her Lexi. Me and her did everything together. Like, we were partners in crime, literally, like partners in crime. We had so much fun just doing whatever we wanted to do and not caring what other people thought. Which Lexi and I were best friends, and we were bad influences on each other. She was a bad influence on me, and I was a bad influence on her. We just brought out like the sketchy side of us. I mean, I guess you can call it. So there's Lexi, and then Lexi's boyfriend, crush thing at the time, we're gonna call him Michael. So Michael, he's one of my best friends still to this day. We talk once in a while, we hang out pretty often, give or take some days. So he's hilarious. I love him. Okay, my thing at the time, we're gonna call him Dallin. Okay, so Dallin, amazing guy, we're still best friends. Like, we had a thing, but it wasn't really a thing. It was just a convenience thing, because Dallin and Michael were best friends, and me and Lexi were best friends. So, you know, it was just kind of like double dates all the time. Like, I wanted to hang out with Sam, Sam wanted to hang out with Michael, I wanted to hang out with Dallin, so we all just kind of, it was just a four-way best friendship, you know? I used to sneak out of my house and go and pick up Lexi and meet up with Dallin and Michael every night, countless of times. So I picked up Lexi and we drove over to Michael's house, and we went to Walmart. Yay, the beginning of our story. So we went to Walmart, I think it was like 2 a.m. 1 or 2 a.m. around there. We went to Walmart planning on stealing, and I don't recommend stealing at all. And I'm pretty sure every single person has stolen at least one little thing from when they were like a baby to now. They've probably stolen something. I'm not happy with my past. I did a lot of things that I shouldn't have done, but the moral of my story is that I learned from my mistakes and I'm not gonna do it again. We went to Walmart with the intention to steal tortillas, cheese, to make quesadillas, and some other snacks along there, because we didn't have any food in like this makeshift house that we were at. So we went to Walmart. Lexi and I were like, we're not gonna be involved in you guys stealing what you're stealing. We're gonna go and look at the betta fish. Lexi had an obsession with betta fish, okay? Like, she had, in her closet, she had her clothes, and then on the shelf that a lot of closets have, it was like betta fish, betta fish, betta fish, betta fish. And it was the funniest thing. And we always talked that, like, we want to have a betta fish together. Like, we want to have a kid together. We want to have a child together. We go over to the betta fish section, and there's like three betta fish ready for someone to buy them, and remember that they are like $1, $2 each fish. So they're really not expensive fish, and I had money on me. I should have just paid for it. Like, that's the thing. There's no reason to even think about stealing it because I had the money for it. If I really wanted a betta fish that bad, I could have bought it. I turn and I look at Lexi, okay, and I go, we should steal a betta fish. And she goes, how do you expect to steal a betta fish? And I look down and I had my huge sweatpants. Like, they were huge on me. So I have these huge baggy sweatpants with pockets. And I turn and I look at Lexi and I said, I'm gonna put it in a rubber glove, put it in my pocket, and walk out. And she goes, okay, let's do this. So then we go and find a rubber glove that they use to like clean out the fish tanks and that kind of stuff. So I grab the rubber glove, put it in my pocket, grab the betta fish that's in the container with the hole on top. I put it under my shirt and I walk like this to the bathroom. And I get in the bathroom and I pour the betta fish into this rubber glove, like a latex glove that has powder in it, which I think was the stupidest thing that I could have done if I wanted to save this betta fish's life from Walmart. So I pour it in the rubber glove, hide or throw away like the betta fish container, put the glove in my pocket, and I'm walking out with my hands in my pocket. So we start walking out to the car, okay? I look across the store and I see Michael and Dallin walking out the store that way. And I are on this side walking out, and then a worker comes, runs up to us, and goes, you stole my betta fish! And I just turned around and I was like, I was putting on the biggest act of my life because I was not getting arrested for a $2 fish that's in my pocket in a rubber glove. So I turned around and I was like, what the fuck are you saying? And the worker was like in my face screaming at me and Lexi. And she was like, you stole my betta fish. I know you stole my betta fish. There's a fish missing. You stole my betta fish. And she was like screaming in my face. And I go, you know, this isn't really that professional of you. Maybe you should back up. And she turns around, looks at another worker and goes, you keep them here. I'm going to go and check the security cameras. And I turn around to and I go, so do you want some chocolate? And we start walking down the aisle that's like, so the entrance is like right here from Walmart, and then they have like the aisle and then it like splits off and like the cash registers are here. So we were walking down this aisle like looking at the like Valentine stuff that was on sale, and I was like, do you want some chocolate maybe? And we're just walking around and I like, we hid behind the shelf and I go, damn, what the fuck am I gonna do? I was like, I'm not getting arrested for a $2 fish in my pocket in a rubber glove. So then she was like, I don't know, Amelia, stash it somewhere. So then I start walking around a little bit more, you know, trying not to make eye contact with that worker, like acting like it's not a big deal that she stopped us when my whole, like, my heart was in my uterus. Like, I was freaking out, okay? So I walk over, and you know, like, the mats in front of, like, the doors, so it, like, stops the mud and all that stuff? They roll it up at the end of the night, and so they roll it this way, and then they flip it, so it's, like, a tunnel, like, in the corner over there. So I walk over, and I pull the fish out of my pocket, I drop it in the tunnel, and I turn around, and I go, like, and I'm talking to the worker, and I was like, this is ridiculous. Can I just leave? Like, I don't feel good. I'm sick. Like, I'm hurting, and I just want to leave. Like, can I leave? If I stole a betta fish, don't you think it, you could see that I stole a betta fish? And she turns and she looks at me and she's like organizing like clothes on this shelf and, or on this rack. She was organizing clothes on this rack. And she turns around and she goes, I'm not holding you here. She is. I don't listen to her. I'm her boss. And I turn around and I go, thank you so much. And so Lexi and I walk out like no big deal. And then right when we get outside, we go, I dropped it for no reason. And I killed the fish for no reason when the other person was going to let us go. She was just going to let us go. So I freaked out for no reason. I killed the fish that we were going to have as a pet together. Dead. Dead because I freaked out. Ah! I don't know how to even express how scared I was. So I get out in the car. We sit down. Michael and Dallin just turn around and look at us and go, what the fuck was that about? Because they saw us sitting there about to walk out when they were walking out. So they thought that we were just going to meet at the car and drive off. 20 minutes later, we get in the car and we're like, I almost got fucked for stealing a betta fish. So that is my story on almost getting caught stealing a betta fish. Mom, if you ever see this, I am so sorry, okay? I didn't know what I was doing back then. I would never do that now. I just wouldn't. Like, it's not classy. It's risky. It's illegal. Like, I wouldn't do it now, and I'm sorry for even doing that back then, but I promise I won't do it again. Okay guys, moral of the story, just don't steal. It's not worth it. You could, if you're above 18 and you steal, just as stupid as a $2 betta fish, you can get arrested and you can get in a lot of trouble when you could have just paid $2 for the thing that you want. It's not worth it. And I learn from my mistakes. I don't steal anymore. I don't do anything illegal anymore that I did in high school. So, I don't know what else to say. I don't know what else to say, except I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up. Subscribe down below. Hit that notification bell and comment. I hope you guys have a beautiful day, and don't forget to smile because it's good for your health. Bye guys.